Hi, don't forget to like and share this video and also subscribe to my YouTube channel and press the notification button so whenever I upload motivational content, you will be informed. Walk into the psychology of achievement, part 4. This session deals with self-image. Like I explained before, the purpose of this series is to help you understand how people who achieve and nations and societies who achieve so much think and behave. So we are delving into the way we think so that we can use these building blocks to change the way we think and improve the quality of our lives, the quality of our families, and the quality of the society we live in. So we are looking at self-image. What is self-image? Self-image is the mental image a person has of who they are and what they are. All of us in our minds have an image of who we are and what we are. This image is with us wherever we go. It is perpetual, and as our thoughts of who we are and what we are changes, this image also changes. This image is determined by your self-esteem, how much value you place on yourself. So as we dealt with self-esteem previously, if you have been able to do the exercises on self-esteem and improve the way you see yourself, the value you place on yourself, the estimation you have of yourself, it will automatically affect your self-image. And for you to also do an effective work on your self-image, you don't just work on your self-esteem and leave it. After working on your self-esteem, you have to also look at your self-image and add value to your self-image. So we are trying to make surgical strikes like a surgeon, looking at those small areas of our lives that we need to make changes in so that we can improve. So as we look at our self-esteem and improve that, it will affect our self-image. And when we come to our self-image and make small changes in our self-image, it will also affect the next aspect of our lives. So self-esteem determines your self-image. Now your self-image will grow or to diminish depending on your self-perception, how you perceive yourself, your self-treatment, and the treatment you receive from others. So how you perceive yourself, how you treat yourself, and how you allow others to treat you affect your self-image. When you are asked to describe yourself, what do you say about yourself? How do you dress and keep yourself? Some people dress shabbily. Others dress anyhow, wearing clothes that are not pressed, wearing clothes that are dirty, that are torn, not because they don't have better clothes, but because they are just too darn lazy to have their clothes properly washed and properly pressed. The way you present yourself by your dressing and how you've kept yourself is very important. And that's why we also need to pay attention to how we trim our hair and how we trim our beards and mustaches. If you have a beard and a mustache, how you trim it determines your self-image. Now we have a lot of young people who are trying to look old by growing a beard. And then when they hit a certain age, they try to look young by shaving the beard. Such people have a self-image problem. You can't pretend to look old and then later try and pretend to look young. Just be yourself. Allow your natural hair to grow. So dress yourself and keep yourself very well. How do you keep your physical body? Are you in good shape or are you out of shape? You can have the body of an athlete, and you can also have an average body that is well kept. You don't have to bench press 300 pounds or run 5 miles to be in good shape. Just simple exercise will keep you in good shape. So how do you keep your body? Do you have a bloated stomach? How did that bloated stomach come about? What kind of people are your friends? Who are your friends? What kind of people are they? Are they people who disrespect you? Are they people who are fond of insulting you, yet because you feel that without them you can't have any happiness and so you stay in their company? What kind of people are your friends? Your friends affect your self-image. Number 4, how much confidence do you have in your profession? Don't think that, oh, I'm just a teacher, and so you dress anyhow, you keep your body out of shape, you just talk to people anyhow, you behave yourself anyhow just because you are a teacher. No, you can magnify yourself and magnify your office and let people see the kind of quality teacher you are. So number 1, how do you dress and keep yourself? Number 2, how do you keep your physical body? Number 3, what kind of people are your friends? 4, how much confidence do you have in your profession? If you are a storekeeper, do you have confidence that you are the greatest storekeeper and so you dress and keep yourself well? Or do you think this is a rubbish job and so you do the work anyhow? That affects your self-image. How do you walk? Do you walk with a spring in your step, with confidence? Or do you shuffle along like an old drunk? The way you walk is affected by your self-image. 6. How do you want to influence people? Do you endeavor to be a positive role model for others? Or do you care less about others? If you endeavor to be a positive role model for others, then you will live your life in a way that will convince people to emulate your behavior. But if you are a negative role model for others, then what you do is that you live anyhow, not knowing that some people are copying you and they will also end up living anyhow. 7. What comments do you make about your appearance? Oh, I'm just a useless person. Oh, as for me, I always dress like that. What comments do you tolerate others to make about your appearance? Do you allow people just to make any comment about your appearance? Or when they make a comment about your appearance that you don't like, you tell them, I'm going to do something about that, so let's forget about this, okay? Let's pretend it didn't happen, I'm going to correct it. Or do you just accept what they say about you? 8. What comments do you make about your performance? When you do something and you fail, do you call yourself a failure? Or do you say, I've discovered one way of not doing this? Let me find a better way to do this. Or do you say to yourself, I'm a loser, I'm worthless, I'm useless? What do you say about your performance? What do you tolerate others to say about your performance? When you fail or you disappoint or you make a mistake, do you accept people saying, no, don't mind, it's a loser, ignore her, she's useless? You should not accept people making such comments about you unless you are making those comments about yourself in the first place, which then means that your self-image is damaged. 9. What comments do you make about your worth? How valuable you are. What comments do you tolerate others to make about your worth? Oh, sir, you know him, Yinfasu. There's no value for him. He's worthless and he's useless. Is that what you tell yourself? If you think like this, you will always be a loser. If this is the image you have of yourself in your mind, you will always be a loser. The positive effects will be the results you have of a positive self-image. The negative effects will be the results you have of a negative self-image. So your self-image determines the effects in your life. Now, what are the dangers of not rebuilding your self-image? Because as I said in a previous series, that a lot of this was built up when we were a child. And so we need to pull down and rebuild our image, our self-esteem, and then our self-image. So what are the dangers of not rebuilding your self-image? 1, you will look down on yourself. You will always look down on yourself. 2, you will think that others are better than you. So when the time comes for you to step up and do something and take the credit for it, you find it difficult to do so because you think that others are better than you. Why? Because you look down on yourself. 3, you will take terrible care of yourself, those around you, and your environment. When you don't rebuild your self-image, you will take terrible care of yourself. You will not take good care of yourself. And you will also not take good care of those who are around you. That includes your wife, that includes your husband, that includes your children, your family members, your colleagues. Because you are not taking good care of yourself. Number 4, you will talk down to yourself and accept defeat every time because you cannot see yourself as a champion. You talk down to yourself, I'm worthless. There's nothing good that I can do in this world. I'm useless. I'm hopeless. And you say this over and over to yourself. And you cannot see that you are a champion. You see, every one of us is a champion. But a lot of us have had our lives shrouded by disappointment and failure. And so we think we are a disappointment and we think we are a failure, which is not true. You are a champion. But if you don't rebuild your self-image, that championship character will never come out. 5. You will keep the company of those who disrespect and talk down to you. This explains why there are people who are working in companies where the owners and the managers talk rubbish to them, talk trash to them, and they still remain in that place because they have a terrible and damaged self-image. And they are refusing to rebuild that self-image. Some don't know how to rebuild that self-image. That is why you need to pass this material on to your friends, especially those whom you believe have a very low confidence level. 6. You will not attempt to do anything meaningful with your life. You just move on by like everybody else. You will not try to do something special. Listen, you are special like every other human being. Every human being is special. And so you need to do something meaningful with your life for the sake of your children, for the sake of your siblings, for the sake of your parents, for the sake of the society. Do something meaningful, but most importantly, for your own good sake. So that one day, when you are about to die, you will not regret having lived this life. So what are the steps to rebuilding your self-image? Remember that how you see yourself will determine how people will see you. And this will drive what you say about yourself and what you do. So how you see yourself will determine how people see you. And this will determine what you say about yourself and also determine what you do. How you see yourself will determine what people or how people see you. How you see yourself will determine how people see you. And this will determine what you say about yourself and what you do with your life. So how do you develop a new self-image as a wealthy, prosperous, capable, responsible, and influential person? 1. Look at yourself in the mirror every day and say wonderful, incredible, fantastic, lovely, and beautiful things about yourself. Look at yourself in the mirror. If you don't have a mirror, go and buy one. Or just turn your phone off. Or let the screen blank and look at the image in the screen and say to yourself, you are good. You are successful. You are happy. You are full of joy. You are capable. You are a champion. You are capable. You are a champion. You are happy. You are successful. You are fantastic. Whatever you do will prosper. You are wealthy. You are not a failure. You are not a disappointment. You are a mighty success. You are influential. Keep repeating these things to yourself every day. Every morning when you wake up, when your mind is at its sharpest, when you wake up, say these things to yourself every day. And I promise you, it will build your confidence level. It will. 2. Buy nice clothes for yourself and wear them. Don't wait for special occasions to wear nice clothes. Wear nice clothes as often as you can. It could be as simple as a white shirt, well-pressed, with a trousers, a shirt, and a tie. Or you can just wear beautiful skirts and top. Wear nice clothes. So when you are buying clothes, look for quality, not quantity. Impress your clothes well. Buy nice soap and wash your clothes with those nice soaps. Take good care of your clothing items, the shoes, the socks. If you are wearing accessories like chains, watches, earrings, necklaces, take good care of them. Wear quality ones. Have few but quality ones. If you are wearing makeup, have quality makeup, few but quality makeup, and wear it lightly so that the beauty of your natural skin comes out. Don't wear it so heavily, wear it lightly. Buy nice clothes for yourself. Don't wait for occasions like Christmas, church, Easter, birthdays, and special events to wear your nice clothes. Wear them whenever you want. Every day I wear a shirt, trousers, shoes. Most of the time I wear a tie. Sometimes I wear a suit. Sometimes I wear a waistcoat. And I work from home. And I've realized that since I've started dressing like this, I get more work accomplished at home because I dress as if I'm going to the office. My office is my home, or my home is my office, whichever way you want to put it. So wear nice clothes. I never saw my father dress shabbily. I never saw my mother dress shabbily. Some of you may have seen your parents dress shabbily, but that does not have to be for you. You must set a better example for yourself and for your children. Number 3, spend time in places of class, elegance, and grandeur. I mentioned this in my previous section. Go to a hotel, a very nice hotel, order for a bottle of malt or just a drink or just a bottle of water. Sit there and enjoy the atmosphere. Observe the people that come in. Decide if you can afford just to spend one night in a hotel. Just attend an event and just be there with people. Sometimes it might be an event that it might not bring you so much benefit, but just want to be in the atmosphere of people who think on a much higher level than you. If your regional minister is hosting a press conference and you know important people are going to be there, just show up and see the kind of people that are there. Just book an appointment with your bank manager. And when you go to his office, just tell him, oh, sir, I just want to see who you are, know who you are, and tell you how pleased I am with your service. You may not be happy with the service. Just want to just get into the atmosphere and the office of a bank manager. Just to see the office, get the experience of being around somebody who is the branch manager of a bank or another company. 4, give to total strangers. Now, I'm not talking about beggars. I'm talking about people who are on the same class as you or even higher. You can board a vehicle and pay for the person sitting next to you or the people in the car. Pay their fare. Look for opportunities to give to people you know and to give to strangers. You can just meet somebody and say, excuse me, madam, excuse me, sir, just one moment. And then hand them an envelope. He said, God asked me to give this to you. And just give it to them. It might be 5 cedis, 10 cedis, whatever it might be. But this person will think, and it will make you feel so good having given to somebody. Give to total strangers. 5. Select a variety of role models. That's right. Select a variety. Don't just have one role model. Have a variety of role models, with each one serving a purpose. So have a business role model. Someone who renders excellent service in business. Have a family role model of who the ideal husband, the ideal wife. Have a role model for your family. Have a role model for your business. Have a spiritual role model. Have a health role model. Someone who's in very good shape and you want to be like that person. Have a financial role model. Someone who's wealthy, who has money, and you want to be like that person. And learn from them. Read their books. Listen to their interviews. Watch documentaries about them. 6. Take wonderful pictures of yourself and keep them for future references so you can see how well you are improving. Take wonderful pictures of yourself. Don't take the pictures and upload them onto social media. Just take pictures of yourself and keep those pictures. In time, look back on those pages and see how far God has brought you. So these are some of the things we can do to improve the quality of our self-image. Remember, you have an image of yourself in your mind and it's there all the time. What you have to do is to improve the quality of that image and work on it so that the quality of your life and choices can also be improved. This is Afro Lance Banson saying, God bless you.